You are listening to a cassette recording of a channeling session from the Raw Contact, a series of 106 sessions that were conducted between 1981 and 1984 using a form of tuned trance telepathy. Throughout these sessions, a group of entities identified as Ra shared information regarding the Law of One, spiritual evolution, and a variety of esoteric topics through a series of questions and answers. The full text transcript of these recorded sessions can be read for free at lnlresearch.org, where you can also learn more about this audio and its origins. This recording is intended for personal study and is not available for commercial use. Please contact LNL Research if you wish to use this audio in any other way.
Second. Raw 42, March 22nd.
I have a question I'm balancing. It's quite long that I have read here. Question number one. We'll copy it directly into the book as it is. If you could answer it without me reading it, it would save time. Otherwise, I will read it.
I am Ra. We understand your desire to preserve your opportunity. However, a summary of the query would be well for if we answer a mentally requested a query. This a query shall not be published if you wish this answer to be for a private use only. We shall proceed.
I will just read very rapidly the question then. I'm going to make a statement and ask you to comment on its degree of accuracy. I'm assuming that the balanced entity would not be swayed either towards positive or negative emotions by any situation which you might confront. By remaining unemotional in any situation, the balanced entity may clearly discern the appropriate and necessary responses in harmony with the Law of One for each situation. Most entities on our planet found themselves unconsciously caught up into every emotional situation which they come in contact with according to their own unique biases, and because of these biases are unable to see clearly, teach learning opportunities and appropriate response in each emotional situation, and must therefore, through a process of much trial and error and enduring of resulting pain, repeat such situations many, many times until they become consciously aware of the need to balance their energy centers and thus their responses and behaviors. Once a person becomes consciously aware of the need to balance their energy centers and responses, the next step is to allow the appropriately positive or negative responses to emotional situations to flow smoothly through their being without retaining any of the emotional coloration after it has been consciously observed and allowed to flow through the being. And I'm assuming that this ability to consciously observe the positive or negatively charged energy flowing through the being may be augmented by practice of the balancing exercises you have given us, with the result in balance being achieved for the entity, which would allow him to remain unemotional and undistorted in regards to the Law of One in any situation, much like the objective viewer of a television movie. Is this correct?
I am Ra. This is an incorrect application of the balancing which we have discussed. The exercise of first experiencing feelings and then consciously discovering their antitheses within the being has as its objective and not the smooth flow of feelings, both positive and negative, while remaining unswayed, but rather the objective of a becoming unswayed. This is a simpler result and it takes much practice, shall we say. The catalyst of experience works in order for the learned teachings of this density to occur. However, if there is seen in the being a response, even if it is simply observed, the entity is still using the catalyst for learned teaching. The end result is that the catalyst is no longer needed. Thus, this density is no longer needed. This is not indifference or objectivity, but a finely tuned compassion and love which sees all things as love. This seeing elicits no response due to catalytic reactions. Thus, the entity is now able to become co-creator of experiential occurrences. This is a truer, a balance.
I will attempt to make an analogy. If an animal, shall I say, a bull in a pen, attacks you because you have wandered into his pen, you get out of his way rapidly, but you do not blame him, or you do not have much of an emotional response other than the fear response that he might damage you. However, if you encounter another self in his territory and he attacks you, your response may be more of an emotional nature, creating physical bodily responses. Am I correct in assuming that when your response to the animal and to the other self, seeing both as the creator and loving both and understanding their action in attacking you, is the action of their free will, then you have balanced yourself correctly in this area? Is this correct?
I am Ra. This is basically correct. However, the balanced entity will see in the seeming attack of an other self the causes of this action, which are in most cases of a more complex nature than the cause of the attack of the second density, a bull, as was your example. Thus, this balanced entity would be open to many more opportunities for service to a third density other self.
Would a perfectly balanced entity feel an emotional response when being attacked by the other self?
I am Ra. This is correct. The response is a love.
In the illusion that we now experience, it is difficult to maintain this response, especially if the entity's attack results in physical pain. But I assume that this response should be maintained even through physical loss of life or extreme pain. Is this correct?
I am Ra. This is correct. And further, is of a major or principal importance in understanding, shall we say, a principle of balance. Balance is not indifference, but rather the observer not blinded by any feelings of separation, but rather fully imbued with love.
In the last session, you made the statement that we, that is Ra, spent much time, space, in fifth density, balancing the intense compassion gained in fourth density. Could you expand on this concept with respect to what we were just discussing?
I am Ra. The fourth density, as we have said, abounds in compassion. This compassion is a folly when seen through the eyes of wisdom. It is the salvation of a third density, but creates a mismatch in the ultimate balance of the entity. Thus, we as a social memory complex of a fourth density had the tendency towards compassion even to a martyrdom in aid of other selves. When the fifth density harvest was achieved, we found that in this a vibratory level, flaws could be seen in the efficacy of such unrelieved compassion. We spent much time, space in contemplation of those ways of the Creator which imbue love with wisdom.
I would like to try to make an analogy for this in third density. Many entities here feel great compassion toward relieving the physical problems of third density, other selves, by administering to them in many ways, bringing them food if there is hunger, as there is in the African nations now, bringing them medicine if they believe they require it, administering to them medically, and being selfless in all of these services to a very great extent. This is creating a polarization or a vibration that is in harmony with green ray or fourth density. However, it is not balanced with the understanding of fifth density that these entities are experiencing catalyst and a more balanced administration to their needs would be to provide them with the learning necessary to reach the state of awareness of fourth density than it would to be to administer to their physical needs at this time. Is this correct?
I am wrong. This is incorrect. To a mind, body, spirit complex which is starving, the appropriate response is the feeding of the body. You may extrapolate from this on the other hand, however, you are correct in your assumption that the green ray response is not as refined as that which has been imbued with wisdom. This wisdom enables the entity to appreciate its contributions to the planetary consciousness by the quality of its being without regard to activity or a behavior which expects results upon visible planes.
Then, why do we have the extreme starvation problem in generally in the area of Africa at this time? Is there any metaphysical reason for this, or is it purely a random occurrence?
I am Ra. Your previous assumption was correct as to the catalytic action of this starvation and ill health. However, it is within the free will of an entity to respond to this polite of other selves and the offering of the needed foodstuffs and substances is an appropriate response within the framework of your learned teachings at this time, which involve the growing sense of love for and service to other selves.
What is the difference in terms of energy center activation between a person who represses emotionally charged responses to emotionally charged situations and the person who is balanced and therefore truly unswayed by emotionally charged situations?
This query contains an incorrect assumption to the truly balanced entity. No situation would be emotionally charged. With this understood, we may say the following. The repression of emotions depolarizes the entity insofar as it then chooses not to use the catalytic action of the space-time present in a spontaneous manner, thus dimming the energy centers. There is, however, some polarization towards positive if the cause of this repression is a consideration for other selves. The entity which has worked long enough with the catalyst to be able to feel the catalyst but not find it necessary to express reactions is not yet balanced, but suffers no depolarization due to the transparency of its experiential continuum. Thus, the gradual increase in the ability to observe one's reactions and to know the self will bring the self ever closer to a true balance. Patience is requested and suggested for the catalyst is intense upon your plane, and its use must be appreciated over a period of consistent learn teaching.
How can a person know when he is unswayed by an emotional charged situation, if he is repressing the flow of emotions, or if he is in balance and truly unswayed?
I am Ra. We have spoken to this point. Therefore, we shall briefly reiterate that to the balanced entity, no situation has an emotional charge, but is simply a situation like any other, in which the entity may or may not observe an opportunity to be of service. The closer an entity comes to this attitude, the closer an entity is to balance, you may note that it is not our recommendation that reactions to catalyst be repressed or suppressed unless such reactions would be a stumbling block not consonant with the law of one to an other self. It is far, far better to allow the experience to express itself in order that the entity may then make fuller use of this catalyst.
How can an individual assess what energy centers within its being are activated and in no immediate need of further attention, and which energy centers are not activated and are in need of immediate attention?
I am Ra. The thoughts of an entity, its feelings or emotions, and least of all, its behavior, are the signposts for the teaching, learning of self by self in the analysis of one's experiences of a diurnal cycle. An entity may assess what it considers to be inappropriate thoughts, behaviors, feelings, and emotions in examining these inappropriate activities of mind, a body, and a spirit complexes, the entity may then place these distortions in the proper vibrational ray, and thus see where work is needed.
In the last session, you said the self is conscious to a great enough extent of the workings of the catalyst of fasting and the techniques of programming made through concentration of the will and the faculty of faith alone cause reprogramming without the analogy of fasting, diet, or other analogous body complex disciplines. What are the techniques of programming which the higher self uses to ensure that the desired lessons are learned or are attempted by the third density self in our third density incarnational laboratory?
I am Ra. There is but one technique for this a growing or nurturing of will and faith. And that is the focusing of the attention. The attention span of those you call children is considered short. The spiritual attention span of most of your peoples is that of the child. Thus, it is a matter of wishing to become able to collect one's attention and hold it upon the desired programming. This, when continued, strengthens the will. The entire activity can only occur when there exists faith that an outcome of this discipline is possible.
Can you mention some exercises for helping to increase the attention span?
I am such exercises are common among the many mystical traditions of your entities. The visualization of a shape and a color which is of personal, inspirational quality to the meditator is the heart of what you would call the religion of simple shapes and colors which have no innate inspirational quality to the entity, form the basis for what you may call your magical traditions. Whether you image the rose or the circle is not important. However, it is suggested that one or the other path towards visualization be chosen in order to exercise this faculty. This is due to the careful arrangement of shapes and colors which have been described as visualizations by those steeped in the magical tradition.
As a youth, I was trained in the engineering sciences, which include the necessity for three-dimensional visualization for the processes of design. Would this be helpful to as a foundation for the type of visualization that you're speaking of, or would it be of no value?
I am wrong. To you, the questioner, this experience was valuable to a less sensitized entity. It would not gain the proper increase of concentrative energy.
Then the less sensitized entity should use what should he use for the proper energy.
I am Ra in the less sensitized individual, the choosing of a personally inspirational images is appropriate. Whether this inspiration be the rose which is of a perfect beauty, the cross which is of perfect sacrifice, the Buddha which is the all being in one, or whatever else may inspire the individual.
I had one experience in meditation, which I've spoken of before, which was very profound approximately 20 years ago, a little less. What disciplines would be most applicable to recreate this situation and this type of experience?
I am Ra. Your experience would best be approached from the ceremonial magical stance. However, the wanderer or adept shall have the far greater potential for this type of experience, which, as you have undoubtedly analyzed to be the case, is a one of an archetypal nature, one belonging to the roots of cosmic consciousness.
Was that in any way related to the Golden Dawn in ceremonial magic?
I am Ra. The relationship was congruency.
Then, in attempting to reproduce this experience, would I then best follow practices for the order of the Golden Dawn in reproducing this?
I am Ra. To attempt to reproduce an initiatory experience is to move shall we say, backwards. However, the practice of this form of service to others is appropriate in your case, working with your associates. It is not well for positively polarized entities to work singly. The reasons for this are obvious.
Then this experience was a form of initiation? Is this correct?
I am Ra. Yes.
Thank you. Using the teach-learning relationship of parent to its child, what type of actions would demonstrate the activation of each energy center in sequence from red through violet?
I am Ra. This shall be the last full query of this working. The entity, child or adult, as you call it, is not an instrument to be played. The appropriate teach-learning device of a parent to child is the open-hearted beingness of the parent and the total acceptance of the beingness of the child. This will encompass whatever material of the child entity has brought into the life experience in this plane. There are two things especially important in this relationship other than the basic acceptance of the child by the parent. Firstly, the experience of whatever means the parent uses to worship and give a thanksgiving to the one infinite creator should if possible, be shared with the child entity upon a daily basis, as you would say. Secondly, the compassion of parent to child may well be tempered by the understanding that the child entity shall learn the biases of service to others or service to self from the parental other self. This is the reason that some discipline is appropriate in the teach learning. This does not apply to the activation of any one energy center. For each entity is unique, and each a relationship with self and other self doubly unique. The guidelines given are only a general for this reason. Is there a brief query before we leave this instrument?
This is not brief enough. Don't bother to answer it at first. I just wondered if certain parts are always removed, the same parts were removed in cattle mutilations. And is that related to the energy centers, and why are these particular parts were removed? But if that is too long an answer, I'll just ask if there's anything we could do to make the instrument more comfortable or improve the contact.
I am Ra. It would be well to respond to the query at another working. The instrument is well. I am Ra. I leave you, my friends, in the love and the light of the infinite Creator. Go forth then, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one infinite Creator. Adonai. Mm-hmm.